Hello and welcome to Bangladesh Today. Bangladesh and India signed a liberal visa agreement when Indian Home Minister Sushilkumar Shinde visited Dhaka on January 28, 2013. Shinde and his Bangladeshi counterpart Mohiuddin Khan Alamgir signed the much-awaited extradition treaty and also linked the revised travel arrangement RTA. The extradition treaty will put in place a legal framework to help both countries in the process of nabbing militants, terrorists and most wanted criminals who try to escape the law by crossing the borders. The treaty also has some refusal provisions. If the extradition of someone poses a threat to a nation's national security, the country concerned might refuse the deportation request.
Just signed the extradition treaty and the revised travel documents, I'm proud to declare that the India and Bangladesh shall embark on a new path of cooperation following the signing of extradition treaty and renewal of revised travel arrangements. These compacts will reinforce the spirit of friendship and partnership between our countries in the area of security, cooperation, and realize the visa regulations leading to the increased exchanges and people-to-people contact. We are committed to the return of criminals and the other fugitives who are seeking shelter in India and wanted by Bangladesh back to Bangladesh. My friend Dr. Alamgir and I have also focused our attention on the development of infrastructure at the border checkpost. Upgradation and development of infrastructure will result in better facilities and the delivery of services at the checkpost, further leading to increase trade and commerce between India and Bangladesh. We have directed our border guarding forces and other concerned authorities to render complete cooperation so that these goals can be achieved within a reasonable time frame. India is committed to making its best efforts to enable and securing a higher level of cooperation in the implementation of the agreements signed between India and Bangladesh under the umbrella of security cooperation. We are willing to facilitate the transfer of sentenced prisoners, thus enabling them to complete their sentences in their own homelands.
After signing the extradition treaty, many top militant leaders of India's northeast hiding in Bangladesh could be handed over to India, and the treaty will also help Bangladesh get its hands on its criminals that are lodged in jails in India. The Indian cabinet, chaired by Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, had recently given the nod to pen the long-awaited extradition treaty.
We are discussing the finalization of standard operating procedure of expeditious verifications of nationality of persons undergoing sentences who are willing to be transferred to their home country. We trust that this new mechanism will achieve the goal envisaged through the signing of the agreement. I am also looking forward to my meeting with the Honorable Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Her Excellency Sheikh Hasina, and Foreign Minister Dr. Dipu Moni. India attaches the utmost importance to strengthening our friendly and cooperative ties with the Bangladesh. India will be happy to aid and assist Bangladesh in the training and capacity building of Bangladesh officers and the police personnel in our best institutions. It is extremely satisfying to note that the current state of our bilateral relations is marked by warmth, cordiality, the trust, and the understanding. We want to make the relationship durable, inclusive, and responsive to the core concern of both sides based on mutual respect and mutual benefits. We wish to work with the people of Bangladesh to realize the full potential of our people. I must also express here that while we discuss on the Bangbandhu's case, you see, the killers are hiding, we will give all the cooperation and we'll try to trace if they are in India and hand it over immediately as soon as we trace them.
India hopes this treaty would make possible the handing over to India of top Ulfa leader Anup Chetia, who is at present lodged in a Bangladeshi prison. The United Liberation Front of Assam Ulfa militant has been languishing in a Dhaka jail after he was arrested in 1997 on the charge of entering Bangladesh without required valid documents. Meanwhile, the other deal that was signed was the friendlier visa agreement for Bangladesh titled Revised Travel Arrangement RTA.
As businessman, but as a citizen of the country, we welcome his visit, because we all know that one of the main purpose of this visit or agenda in this visit is to issuing the visa process much easier than what is happening right now. And we all know that it is not only for the businessman, but for the tourists, the medical patients, the students, all are having some sort of problem. Even up to some extent, it's a great problem to get the visa to enter into India, which was not supposed to be the case. But this visit of Indian Home Minister can be a historical one if we really see that visa issue process is really becoming, in true sense, easy. Because sometime in before, we heard it that it will be easy, but we saw in the name of making it online, it became more complicated. So if it is in true sense really eased, that it will help each and every one in Bangladesh. Because as I told, in India is a big country, is a big economy, having all sorts of facilities there in terms of medical, in terms of tourism. So there are a lot of windows to be opened and to be strengthened only through this particular visa issue. And we, the businessmen in particular, I believe would be very much benefited, because as I mentioned earlier, that lack of initiative is one of the biggest obstacles to grow our business into Indian market.
According to the visa pact, businessmen would be given a 5-year multiple entry visa, and those who want to travel on medical grounds would get a 2-year multiple entry visa, which is extendable for one more year. The new visa agreement will do away with certain restrictions on the visits of business representatives, senior citizens above the age of 65 years, and children below 12. When the new agreement is in place, the number of visas given by India to Bangladeshis will, in all probability, see a considerable rise. The Indian Home Minister also called upon Bangladesh's Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. In other news, activists of the biggest Islamic party, Jamaat-e-Islami Bangladesh, and its student wing, the Islami Chhatra Shibir, continued their ways of disrupting the political equilibrium in the country after protests stemmed from the fact that former Jamaat leader Abdul Kalam Azad had been sentenced to death during the war crimes trials. At least 50 people, including policemen, were injured in Dhaka on January 28 as protesters set off crude explosives and threw bricks at the police, who tried to scatter them with tear gas and batons and by firing bullets in the air. In another protest on January 29, the Jamaat activists set at least 4 vehicles on fire in Dhaka and vandalized around 200 more across the country. Noted Bangladeshi journalist Shariar Kabir, among others, has welcomed the verdict by the court and believes that justice has finally been delivered.
Indeed, I am happy, and it is not because that I am a member of a family of the victims of the war, or I am campaigning for the trial of the war criminals for the last 21 years. But what we see that inter-nation was waiting for this justice, for this trial for the last 41 years. The genocide, what we have witnessed in 1971, that is considered as the most horrendous genocide since Second World War. And subsequent government after the liberation war was over, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujib's government took initiative to try the war criminals, but that was done under the present law, which is very much conventional law that didn't define genocide, crimes against humanity, or war crimes. So this is a law which was enacted in 1973 that said for the first time that defined these international crimes as offenses under a domestic law. So this is a domestic law. We have tried certain international crimes under a domestic law in a domestic court. And indeed, it has made a history, not only for Bangladesh, but also for those countries, those who are the victims of genocide and campaigning, crying for justice for the last 100 years, starting from Mexico, Armenia, Rwanda, and many, many countries. Few countries were able to try the war criminals, but again, that was under the international court. But Bangladesh has created a history. We have tried war crimes, crimes against humanity, genocide under a domestic court in our domestic legal system.
Kabir also said that Bangladesh had set an example during this war crimes trial and that this would inspire other countries to ensure that justice is handed out in such cases.
This verdict, what I believe, it will also help the tribunal for further, there are many, many cases still pending in the tribunal, and it will also help in other verdict also. And it will also help for the government to try some organization with the individuals, because the trial, this verdict has clearly mentioned Jamaat-e-Islami was one of the main perpetrators of the Pakistani occupied army. And they are responsible for creating Razakar al-Badr al-Shams. And this Bachu Razakar, whose verdict was given, he was a member of the Razakar Bahini, the Razakar troops. And now time has come, but we were campaigning for the last 21 years. Government should try, the tribunal should try, organizations along with the individuals. And this is nothing new. In Nuremberg tribunal, we have seen seven organizations were tried along with 22 Nazi war criminals. So if we want to stop repetition of genocide, if we want to stop war crimes, and if we want to ensure peace, definitely the perpetrators should be brought to book, as well as the organizations that prompted, that justified this killing in the name of religion, what we have seen in 1971, or any other reason, whatever we have seen during the Second World War, during the Nazi Holocaust. So that should be tried, and otherwise we cannot claim that we are a civilized nation. Otherwise we cannot ensure justice to the victims of the war. Otherwise we cannot ensure peace for the future generation.
The Jamaat-e-Islami leaders are accused of abetting the Pakistani army in the genocide, rape and murder of millions in the 1971 Liberation War. Abul Kalam Azad, alias Bachu Razakar, was accused of collaborating with Pakistani forces in the murder of Hindus. He was found guilty of seven charges and acquitted in one. In one case, he was accused of killing at least 12 Hindus while shooting indiscriminately along with Pakistani soldiers. An arrest warrant for Azad was issued in April, but the police was unsuccessful in finding him during raids at his office and residence, as he was believed to have fled to Pakistan via Nepal. That's all we have for you in Bangladesh Today this week. Thank you for watching.
The spirit of friendship and partnership between our countries in the area of security, cooperation, and realize the visa regulations leading to the increased exchanges and people-to-people contact. were committed to the return of criminals and the other fugitives who are seeking shelter in India and wanted by Bangladesh back to Bangladesh. My friend Dr. Alamgir and I have also focused our attention on the development of infrastructure at the border checkpost. Upgradation and development of infrastructure will result in better facilities and the delivery of services at the checkpost, further leading to increase trade and commerce between India and Bangladesh. We have directed our border guarding forces and other concerned authorities to render complete cooperation so that these goals can be achieved.
It has some refusal provisions. If the extradition of someone poses a threat to a nation's national security, the country concerned might refuse the deportation request.
Just signed the extradition treaty and the revised travel documents. I'm proud to declare that the India and Bangladesh shall embark on a new path of cooperation following the signing of extradition treaty and renewal of revised travel arrangements. These compacts will reinforce.
Visited Dhaka on January 28, 2013. Shinde and his Bangladeshi counterpart, Mohiuddin Khan Alamgir, signed the much-awaited extradition treaty and also linked the revised travel arrangement, RTA. The extradition treaty will put in place a legal framework to help both countries in the process of nabbing militants, terrorists and most wanted criminals who try to escape the law by crossing the borders. The treaty also Hello and welcome to Bangladesh Today. Bangladesh and India signed a liberal visa agreement when Indian Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde